YouTube, it's your boy Fishing Ken, Hook City TV. You know I got my main man with me.
Hook City.
It's about to go down. Hey man, we're out here today. Listen, we're still dealing with cold fronts. Yes, it's still the springtime. This is not an old video. We are now in spring. But we've been in a cold front for about a week. I think we're finally coming out of it, but it's still looking nasty. We still got rain doing a little bit of falling. It rained this morning. I believe that those males, I'm in a different body of water now too, but I done ran way up an arm, and I believe the males are not on the banks, but they're just off the banks again. So I just want to prove that theory again. It's something we really need to drive home, because listen, the crappie are in the creeks and you need to know how to locate and catch them. That's what we out here to do today, man. Y'all stay tuned, get ready, because it's about to go down. Hey, before this thing gets rolling, you might as well like, comment, and subscribe. Say what's up to you, boy. If you got any questions for Hook, if you want to hear him sing that Put Him in the Cooler, his new single out right now.
I love when they go in the cooler.
Yes, sir. Y'all better check it out, man. Hey, go ahead and do those things. It's about to go down right now. I believe we're going to be able to find these fish real close to this main channel, going right into this arm of this creek. Y'all stay tuned. We're about to figure out what it is. Dad, what you using real quick, man?
ACC crappie stick.
What length? Okay, 12 footer maybe?
That's a 12 foot ACC.
Two-piece rod, guys. Y'all can find them at ACC Crappie Sticks, STIX.com. Also using an ACC head on that jig.
ACC jig head and a
brush pile jig. Okay.
Peg with a weight.
With a 1/8 ounce weight peg.
Right.
About what, 10 inches, 12 inches above your bait. And that's just so we can get down on those fish fast, man. It's what we've been using for a while now. I got the same setup pretty much. I'm gonna be doing the ACC crappie sticks head as well. You see that, the eye on that jig, man. And I'm actually using brush pile jigs, Wyatt's Blue Magic, man. So we'll see what that jig does for us. Oh, wait a minute. And I got a little swaggy. I got a little swaggy on y'all, man. We'll see. You can get those from brushpilejigs.com, man. Let's go, baby.
Come on.
You on him? Listen, 11 foot of water. Listen, I think they like orange. I think they like orange, man.
He hit this orange brush pile jig. It's a nice fish, man. Probably about 11 and a half.
Quality eater right there, man. Quality eater. Guys, they safe today. We've harvested some the other day. So these are safe today. I don't know if that's a male or a female. I'm going to guess with the belly on it, that's a female.
Female.
Now, I'm going to tell you this time of year, y'all, sometimes if you drop those fish in your live well, when they get in that live well, those hormones really pop out and you'll notice that you're catching males. We'll put a few in the live well just to show you, and we'll release them later on today. But those fish will darken up in the live well. But males and females are being caught out here. That one can go back, Dad.
Okay, here we go.
Yes, sir. God dog it, man. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's just hard-headed. And if you don't know how to stay on that fish, you ain't catching that fish, man. Wind blowing. I know y'all can hear that gush, y'all. I got another one. It just took me putting it on his head. Got dog. Another keeper fish, y'all. Wise Blue Magic. It could be a female. She kind of got some belly to her. That tough jig, boy. That juggle put line him right back up on that ACC head. Get right back into it. Let's go, baby. Okay, we got Dad set up. Approaching the fish again. Left. See? You go to looking at that screen, Dad. See what I'm saying? Left. Stay there. Oh man. Tell you
another
what, guys.
Keeper.
Yes, sir.
Fish on this orange. It's doing pretty good so far.
Tell you, let me see that orange, man. That look like a pot of gold. Yeah. High contrast. We got some lightly stained water. See that fish, man. That's another good eater, man.
Another good eater.
Another good eater.
Brush pile jig.
Yes, sir. Now listen, I'm gonna tell you something. If you're looking for a reason to get a long rod, that's the reason right there, man. You want to be able to reach out and catch those fish without getting up too close on them. We got another one, Dad. Drop that one in the water real light, real light, real light. All right, here, let's see if we can grab this other one real quick. We're gonna get close to him before you drop on it. Dealing with the wind, but we found ourselves a little bit of wind block, so it's not just horrible. Got a little bit of boat slap. Just drop it in. Left.
Woo-wee!
Slapped you and called you Jesse.
Yeah, he hit it.
You get that jig out of here, Jesse.
Yeah, he came for it.
Now that...
Now he came for it.
Listen to me. That's the fish. I'm on the fish. I just want y'all to know, guys. So I was making sure I recorded Dad's reaction, but I was watching that fish at the same time. Let me tell you something. He ain't went nowhere. Regroup. Let's see if he'll do it again.
Yeah. He was so
don't,
nice.
Don't drop.
He would do it twice.
He'll do it twice. Let's get to about 7 foot of water. 7 foot away. Left. Left. Yep.
He did it twice.
He did it twice. And that's a man, too. He did it twice.
He did it twice.
Ooh.
Yes, sir.
Ooh-wee.
Two slices of bread.
Fish and bread keep the family fed.
Yeah, man, that's a nice boy there.
Yes, sir.
See if he's gonna blacken up.
You want to see? Yeah, because he ain't got a whole lot of belly. That might be a male, that's man.
It might be a male.
We're gonna get the live well started, y'all. Y'all remember this. Stay tuned, man. At the end of the video, we're gonna do a live well check and see if that's a male or a female. In the comment section, is this a male or a female crappie? Let me see the belly on it, Dad.
I don't know.
Is that a male or a female? What we got here? We're gonna see what she gonna do or he gonna do. I'm gonna get the live well started, guys. We'll be right back. So y'all might be wondering, like, what can I pick up from what Ken has said so far? Well, listen, this is what I want y'all to know. There's a few key things that I said. Number one, yes, it's the springtime. If y'all are not familiar with the channel, man, if y'all are new to the channel, we're in North Texas. I'm from Fort Worth, baby. Stand up. Listen, we're in North Texas. Water temps are 55 degrees. We're coming off of a cold front. These are things that you should be thinking about in your head. It's still in the morning, but these fish are going to be doing this all day. But what I want you to key in on is I said that I went up into a creek arm and I followed the main creek channel. Okay. So I want y'all to start thinking about those types of things. So if you're on your lake, you're looking for spawning fish, guess what? Go check out a creek arm. Go check out one of the arms of the lake. I like to go to the south end of the lake first always. That's just what I've just learned to do. But any creek arm, go into one of these arms and go in there. I'm not saying go to the mouth. I'm saying go up in there, man. Look for some shallower water. Look for things like laydowns. You want to look for grass that you might see growing, trees, things like that might be in the water. And key in on those things. As the water warms back up, we come out of this cold front even more. Guess what's going to happen? Those fish are going to push right back up onto the bank. So if you can find them suspended in the middle and it gets warm, the males for sure are going back up to the banks first, the females to follow. A lot of that action you'll see early on at nighttime. And then as we get here in Texas, as we get into April and May, those fish will be seen more even on the main lake, man, on the banks. So that's what I want y'all to key in on right now. We're gonna keep catching these fish, man. I hope y'all are enjoying. Again, I need all the thumbs up so I can get. We're trying to let YouTube know that we love these videos. Cause we love these videos, right? Right?
Oh, man.
Guys, and it's a big one too. Listen, y'all. We were getting ready to shoot our next scene. And that Wise Blue Magic got tragic. Let me tell you something. I had this thing sitting on the side just like this. Because I was recording Dad. I looked down at the live scope and I could see my bait. And the next thing I know, I saw something lining up on it. Look what was lining up on it. That Wide Blue Magical Fool, man. If they didn't want that, I don't know what to tell you. That's definitely a female. We're going to put her right back in the water, man. But that, man, look at the size of that fish, man. God, that was straight up accident. We're going to put it back in the water. She can go. Listen, I just gave some hope to some of those out there that don't have live scope. I just gave hope to some of you all out there that don't have live scope, man. Some of y'all are still out there spider rigging. Cool, really cool technique. And I'm gonna tell you something. If you can even do some spider rigging and lay those poles out and do some really slow trolling, you might just come up on some of these fish I'm talking about. Again, do not let these spring cold fronts deter you, man. Let's stay at it. I don't know if y'all can see that out there at 28 foot, but we're approaching another fish, man. Again, we're gonna approach slow, and Dad's gonna drop when he gets to about 7 foot.